Komodo is set in Komodo, Indonesia, where I did my dive master. I was diving with sharks and manta rays every day for a month. It was actually the best month of my life. So it's a beautiful place, and the book describes all those dives, really the most beautiful things I've ever seen anywhere in the world. But it also imagines my mother and sister coming to visit me there. And the whole book is told from my sister's point of view, and it includes her anger at me for my divorce and her difficulty in raising twins with a husband who didn't help at all for the first 5 years. So it turns out it's a book really about motherhood and about the stresses of raising twins alone, and is, you know, all made up because they didn't come visit me there. But still, I might get in trouble, so don't tell my family that I've written the book, please. This main character, Tracy, came from really being disturbed about how my sister was affected by having to raise kids without help from her husband, and by how she felt put under too much pressure for the first 5 years, with no free time and constant demands and noise and not enough sleep. And the character was built from that experience, but also became something else in the fiction. Was built also through her anger at me for my divorce, where she really loved my ex-wife and felt that I was taking away a sister from her. And then the character was also affected by the place, by the diving. You know, the characters of the brother and sister go diving together in Komodo, and there's something quite terrible that ends up happening on one of the dives. And Tracy has to ask questions about herself, about who she is and what's happening, and about her rage and why there's nothing to stop her anymore from doing things that otherwise before she would have known not to do. Komodo, the place is important in all of my novels. I write through description of the landscape, whether it's Alaska or California. It was nice to write about Indonesia, a completely different landscape. And it's this underwater world where constantly I had the experience of thinking, oh my God, this is the most beautiful thing I've seen in my life, or this is the best day of my life. But then 2 days later, I would think, oh my God, this is the best day of my life. It kept happening. It was really extraordinary. That 1 month was very hard in some ways, but was by far the best month that I've had. And I think that what I was doing in describing the place is trying to reach back in time. That in Komodo, when you're down there, in that world with all the coral that's still pristine, that's not destroyed, and you're with manta rays, which are enormous, you know, they're like 8 meters across, the manta rays, and with all the sharks, you can feel like you're going back 100 million years, that you're going back before people, and you're seeing the world before it was destroyed by us or changed by us. And so I think that's what I was trying to do in describing the place, is reach back to that earlier sense of being in the world. And it's a kind of refuge for Tracy. You know, she's under so much pressure as a mother, but she finds this kind of refuge and a better world underwater.